The house is now ready for its final colors and finishing touches. And don't forget, you can get sneak peeks and behind the scenes of our videos on our Facebook page, Rosie's World. Welcome back to This Old Dollhouse. During this entire makeover, the craft stores were closed due to COVID. So, I'll be using cheap dollar store craft paint. They still work, but it takes twice the number of coats. Okay, let's get started. Painting is done. It took 5 coats of this cheap paint. For the side of the house, I'm going to glue strips of Velcro here and here. It's so that I can attach signs and decorations. I just happen to have pink Velcro. I cut it to fit. This is the soft side of the Velcro. There, done. I did the same here and the other side. I wanted to do the same to the front, but I couldn't get the Velcro to stick to the wood. The hot glue just peeled off. I guess the two surfaces were too smooth. I had to figure another way to do this. I got this craft stick and left one side unpainted, and this square dowel with also one side unpainted. I'm hoping the two unpainted sides will hold the hot glue. And they did. Here it is. It's all painted now. To make the store sign, I folded a strip of cardstock paper like this. It'll sit on the sign holder like this. I'll be gluing it to a strip of pink foam sheet. This is the front of the store sign, and it sits on the sign holder. So now, this strip of white cardstock paper is where I'll put the letters. To attach this to the pink backing, I have these swirly embellishments with a split pin on the back. Just gonna push them into this foam plate so I can paint them. I got these swirly things long time ago from Michaels. These will hold the letter layer to the backing. The split pin makes it easy. The letter layer fits in like this. This enables me to change the sign very easily, anytime I want. Now for the letters. I got these magnetic foam letters at the dollar store. There wasn't enough pink letters to complete all my signs. So I have to paint over them. Have to prime the letters first. This is the final color. The magnetic letters attaches to the tin, makes painting a lot easier. And here's the sign. Letter layer is done. I also made a sign with the foam letters unpainted. I made more signs and decorations. This is how I made the triangle pieces. Each triangle has a small piece of Velcro glued to it. It's the prickly side of the Velcro. For the strawberry, I found this template on the internet. I cut it out a little bigger. The green top, I kept the same size. I'll be using 3D fabric paint for the seeds. Gently squeeze, release, and pull up. Done! Now glue the top to the berry. To make new rails for the porch, I'm using this basket from the dollar store. Make sure it's flexible. If the plastic is too hard, it will crack when you cut it. Use sharp utility scissors or a utility knife. I'm going to cut right along this ridge. This edge here makes a perfect top rail. You can get a lot of rails from this one basket. I cut out two pieces for the front porch. This is for the rooftop. I got these candle holders from Value Village. I took some apart and made a daisy chain. These are the large beads. And these are the small beads. Let's put it all together. Starting with the windows. They're painted, washed, and ready to be installed. Now, to attach the sign holder. This was not easy. I had to use carpenter's glue and clamp it for 20 minutes. Okay, the new railings. They go right into the bottoms of the old rails. Look how perfect. It's a bit wobbly, so I'm going to put nails to hold them in place. Mark the spot. I'm using pliers to push the nails in. You have to wiggle and push at the same time. I want half the nail to stick out. The nails hide right under the top rail and holds it in place. If you want to get onto the porch, usually rails get broken, but not these. You just lift them out of the way. Now it's so easy to set up furniture, like these sunny yellow Muskoka chairs or Adirondack chairs, depending where you're from. Woohoo! Look at this! Next, the flower boxes. I got these from the dollar store. Small flowers work best. Just pull them off the stem and stick them in the box. Oh my gosh, this is so pretty. Let's put up the sign. How easy was that? And here's Strawberry Shortcake. And her best friend, Orange Blossom. The sides of the house. Almost done, just the rooftop to install. I'll be doing it off camera because that hot glue gun is really hard to manage. The outside of the house is complete. From top to bottom. Oh, look, a welcome mat. And the girls are having tea. Now that the outside of the house is beautiful, it's time to make some magic on the inside. Can't wait to show you what I'm going to do. See you in part 4 of This Old Dollhouse. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. Check out this video.
Your house is so beautiful. I wish I could have a beautiful house like yours. She'll be fixing up another house. Maybe you can have that one. Oh, you think? Maybe.
Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.